Hey, good afternoon. This is Chris with Westside Technology Solutions. Today's video, I'm talking about CMS related things. If you've been following me, you know I've been kind of trying to make a decision as to what CMS I'll be using for the future with my company and for my clients. As you know, I have quite a bit of experience with Craft CMS. I worked with Craft when I worked at PageWorks. And the first couple websites I've done for my company have also been in Craft CMS, including my own. Pretty cool stuff. Craft CMS 5 just released. I didn't actually realize that. And it also looks like they added a new team license, which was pretty cool. I didn't realize that till today. But as you know, I've been looking to move away from Craft. Back last month, they actually increased their pro license, the price, pretty significantly. And I was already having kind of a hard time making these sites affordable for my customers. I started looking into alternatives a while ago, just trying to find some sort of way to make sites affordable and kind of keep like all the functionality that I could get from Craft. So I looked at quite a few different options. Originally, my idea was to be able to make static sites with JSON, basically create a script that accepts one big JSON object and then it iterates over everything and creates the site. That way I can make these sites very efficiently, thus making it more affordable for my customers. I looked at a tool called Gatsby, which is used for static site generation, and it almost met those needs. And then I came across Next.js, which I think was a much better fit. Next.js is cool because you can create a static website or you can create a dynamic website. And I really like that because I like the idea of creating a static site for somebody who had a very low budget. And then when the time is right, they go and upgrade the site. So then I just needed to find a CMS that would work with this idea. I looked at quite a few of them, one of them being called, I think it was called Casey. I looked at Strappy. And they were both really cool, but there were just a couple things about each of them that just weren't really ideal. After doing more and more research, I finally came across Payload CMS. And today I'm just gonna explain why I'm switching from Craft to Payload.
Hey everyone, I'm James. I'm a co-founder of Payload. If you haven't heard of us yet, we're a code-first headless CMS. We're closing the gap between what you might think of as a headless CMS and a full-on application framework. App frameworks like Laravel and Rails can be great at building out the backend for complex apps, but then you're stuck having to build the entirety of your admin panel completely by yourself, and that takes a bunch of time, especially when you want to do it right.
Yeah, so I actually strongly considered switching over to Laravel. I've used Laravel before and I really like it a lot. But that was the exact problem that I ran into is I didn't want to create a full admin panel that I'd be able to do this stuff in. Also, I was kind of looking to move away from PHP as I have quite a bit more recent experience with Node.js. And these are all things that I would pretty much expect out of a CMS, things that I use in Craft that I become pretty accustomed to. And I wouldn't want to try to implement myself really if I didn't have to. Yeah, so this is just a brief view of the admin panel. It's very simple. One of the cool things about Payload is you can inject components where you need to. So if you want this to look different, you can go ahead and totally customize this to fit your needs. Just skipping ahead a little bit here. Yeah, so for a little bit of context, collections are similar to entries in Craft CMS, and then fields has the same word for both of the two CMSs. Basically, to create collections and fields, you actually write code with Payload. And as James mentions here, that actually does resolve one common problem that I had with Craft CMS, where you have different environments. In Craft CMS, if you change your collection or your entry or a field, it modifies the database and a YAML file that keeps track of all these. So it's in version control, and then you push up the YAML file to your live server, and then Craft says, hey, which one of these do you want to use? Do you want to use what I have in the database, or do you want to use what you've got in your YAML file? And then you've got to choose. And to be fair to Craft, this has really come a long way over the major versions of Craft. But that's one of the nice things about Payload is you don't even have to really deal with it because it's all according to the code base. So if we look at the documentation here for collections, you can see just pretty much how dead simple it is to create a collection. You just create a JSON object here, and then you've got your config options laid out very nicely here. And then you just put it into your payload config file and it reloads. It's super convenient. And then the fields are super simple as well. Here's a text field example. If you just want a text field in one of your collections, you've got your example collection here and you just put it right into the fields array. Super, super intuitive, super simple. One of the advantages of having this being code-based is you can do something like reusing different fields inside of a matrix. When I say matrix in payload, the verbiage is blocks. Blocks is like, it's a repeatable, kind of like a layout builder where it's like you can choose one or many elements to basically build a page. In Craft CMS, there's no way to create one matrix and another and have them share fields. You have to create the same field for two different matrices. Whereas in Payload, it's code-driven, so you can do pretty much whatever you want. One of the other major selling points for me that the other CMSs that were based in Node and Express didn't have was a local API. I really thought there should be a way for the CMS to be able to hydrate data into the Next.js server-side components without having to make HTTP requests. Basically, if I had gone with something like Strapi or Casey, from what I saw is I would have to have a server for my CMS and a server for my front end. And then the front end would have to make HTTP requests over to the server, and the server would respond with the data and then fill up the page with the data, which I thought was really counterintuitive. I thought they should be able to work on the same one. So when I saw that Payload CMS had this feature, naturally I was really excited. I think it's somewhere in here, local API. So yeah, here's the documentation on it. Basically this means instead of having two different servers for what I just described, you can just have one server and then Payload can fill your pages with data without having to make HTTP requests, which is just so much more efficient and definitely enhances developer experience. This video that we just watched and a lot of this documentation is from Payload 2.0, but they also are just on the brink of releasing a new major version that's going to integrate much, much better with Next.js. So it literally is like exactly what I was looking for with a CMS. So I'm really excited. One other thing that was pretty cool about Payload was I was reading through the docs here and I saw an image of a form that had Grand Rapids, Michigan filled out. And I was like, wow, is this form location based? No, it was actually a screenshot. These guys are located in Grand Rapids, just like me. I'm actually getting to meet the Payload team tomorrow, so I'm super excited. Anyway, I'll create another video on how that goes. And if you have any thoughts about your favorite CMS or Payload or Craft, please drop me a like or a comment and let me know. Thank you so much.